Francisco State.
Getting rid of what the attitude is when a person says nigger, or when he says greaser, or when he says chink. Our problem is facing those people and getting those people to take a position and either getting off of our net or getting thrown off of our net. That's what it's about. That's what this life is about. What we want is an education that we can determine for ourselves. We want to be able to determine who our faculty is and what our curriculum is and what books we're going to read and what our course outlines are going to be like and what kind of papers we're going to turn in and what kind of research we're going to do and what kind of people we're going to associate with.
I guess
we'll
take it left. Well, I think you can go to meetings and you can talk and you can, you know, donate money or whatever. But if you can actually be there contributing like your body, I didn't want to stand on the sidelines, you know. And it seemed really a natural thing. Plus, I suppose it also helps that all my friends were doing the same thing, you know.
We turned to our sergeant and called him a name and his wife a name, so we arrested this girl. We went up in pairs. We told her she was under arrest. She screamed, she kicked. We had to drag her off. You almost feel belittled because you're grabbing a girl and you're treating her the same as you would a man because she is under arrest, but you still feel guilty about it. You feel small. I don't like to go out and hit anybody over the head or hurt them. When a few people did get hit over the head, it's an accident.
I'm on a picket line, and I'm captain of Station B, 19th and Holloway. I got a red armband. The police lieutenant comes and he talks to me. We have very pleasant relationships. We laugh and kid together. Suddenly, it all changes.
These guys are hassling Professor Stone. They're endangering the life and limb of everybody here. We've requested them in a peaceful way not to do it, and they persist not doing it. These are the kind of people who plead for murder. I'm not touching you.
Because of an order to pick somebody up off the line, suddenly they charge, they start smashing people. These were the guys I was talking to. Why didn't they come to me? Why are they doing this to me, to my picket line? And I get outraged. And I say, by God, I must never talk to these people again. Never. Because they are my enemy. Then there's the next morning. And they grin. And I kind of grin. And they say, how are you, Mr. Solomon, Professor? And it's very difficult.
I believe that where any group's rights are being imposed upon, or any individual's rights by any others, it is the obligation of government to protect those constitutional rights at the point of bayonet, if necessary.
We've also told the governor, frankly, that we don't want his bayonet when he talked about bringing bayonets on campus. We don't want the National Guard here.
All of the major groups which have been predominantly involved in the crisis here at San Francisco State have had their own version of reality. The trustees have become a symbol. Ayakawa is a symbol. The police are a symbol. The leather jackets and the dark glasses of the Black Panthers are a symbol. What happens is that issues become moral issues. Pretty soon the cry goes up that you can't compromise a moral principle, at which point people simply get locked into their respective positions.
Good morning. Let me start by offering my thanks to the Select Committee of the faculty and the administration and to representatives of the Black Students Union and the Third World Liberation Front for their arduous labors in coming to agreement about unresolved issues that have lain behind so many of our recent campus disturbances.
Today at 3 o'clock, a long siege, 4.5 months hopefully has come to an end. The BSU student leaders and the third world leaders, I think, have come to their political senses, and they have come to terms with the college. A lot of problems remain, but at least one can hope, with fingers crossed, that if we're not out of the woods, that perhaps there's a light at the end of that proverbial tunnel.